أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
ألف لام را. These are the ayat of revelation of a Quran that makes things clear. Again and again will those who disbelieve wish that they had bowed to Allah's will in Islam. Leave them alone to enjoy the good things of this life and to please themselves. Let false hope amuse them. Soon will knowledge undeceive them. Never did we destroy a population that had not a term decreed and assigned beforehand. Neither can a people anticipate its term, nor delay it. They say, O you to whom the message is being revealed, truly you are mad or possessed. Why bring you not angels to us, if it be that you have the truth? We send not the angels down except for just cause. If they came to the ungodly, behold, no respite would they have. We have without doubt sent down the message, and we will assuredly guard it from corruption. We did send messengers before you among the religious sects of old, but never came a messenger to them, but they mocked him. Even so do we let it creep into the hearts of the sinners, that they should not believe in the message, but the ways of the ancients have passed away. Even if we opened out to them a gate from heaven, and they were to continue all day ascending therein, they would only say, Our eyes have been intoxicated, nay, we have been bewitched by sorcery. It is we who have set out the zodiacal signs in the heavens, and made them fair-seeming to all beholders. And moreover, we have guarded them from every evil spirit accursed. But any that gains a hearing by stealth is pursued by a flaming fire bright to see. And the earth we have spread out like a carpet, set thereon mountains firm and immovable, and produced therein all kinds of things in due balance. And we have provided therein means of subsistence, for you and for those whose sustenance you are not responsible. And there is not a thing but its sources and treasures inexhaustible are with us. But we only send down thereof in due and ascertainable measures. And we send the fecundating winds, then cause the rain to descend from the sky, therewith providing you with water in abundance, though you are not the guardians of its stores. And verily, it is we who give life and who give death. It is we who remain inheritors after all else passes away. Thus are known those of you who hasten forward and those who lag behind. Assuredly, it is your Lord who will gather them together, for he is perfect in wisdom and knowledge. We created man from sounding clay, from mud molded into shape, and the jinn race we had created before from the fire of a scorching wind. Behold, your Lord said to the angels, I am about to create man from sounding clay, from mud molded into shape. I have fashioned him in due proportion, and breathed into him of my spirit, fall you down in obeisance unto him. Though the angels prostrated themselves, all of them together. Not so Iblis. He refused to be among those who prostrated themselves. Allah said, O Iblis, what is your reason for not being among those who prostrated themselves? Iblis said, I am not one to prostrate myself to man, whom you did create from sounding clay, from mud molded into shape. Allah said, Then get you out from here, for you are rejected, accursed. And the curse shall be on you till the day of judgment. He said, O my Lord, give me then respite, till the day the dead are raised. Allah said, Respite is granted you, till the day of the time appointed. Iblis said, O my Lord, because you have put me in the wrong, I will make wrong fair seeming to them on the earth, and I will put them all in the wrong. Accept your servants among them, sincere and purified by your grace. Allah said, This way of my sincere servants is indeed a way that leads straight to me. For over my servants no authority shall you have, except such as put themselves in the wrong and follow you. And verily, hell is the promised abode for them all. To it are seven gates. For each of those gates is a special class of sinners assigned. Righteous will be amid gardens and fountains of clear flowing water. Their greeting will be, "Enter you here in peace and security." And we shall remove from their hearts any lurking sense of injury. They will be brothers joyfully facing each other on thrones of dignity. There no sense of fatigue shall touch them, nor shall they ever be asked to leave. Tell my servants that I am indeed the oft-forgiving, most merciful, and that my penalty will be indeed the most grievous penalty. Tell them about the guests of Abram. When they entered his presence and said, "Peace," he said, "We feel afraid of you." They said, "Fear not, we give you glad tidings of a son endowed with wisdom." He said, "Do you give me glad tidings that old age has seized me? Of what then is your good news?" They said, "We give you glad tidings in truth. Be not then in despair." He said, "And who despairs of the mercy of his Lord but such as go astray?" Abram said, "What then is the business of which you have come, O you messengers of Allah?" They said, "We have been sent to a people deep in sin. Excepting the adherents of Lut, them we are certainly charged to save all from harm. Except his wife, who we have ascertained will be among those who lag behind." At length, when the messengers arrived among the adherents of Lut, he said, "You appear to be uncommon folk." They said, "Yea, we have come to you to accomplish that of which they doubt. We have brought to you that which is inevitably due, and assuredly we tell the truth." "Then travel by night with your household, when a portion of the night yet remains, and do you bring up the rear. Let no one amongst you look back, but pass on whither you are ordered." And we made known this decree to him, that the last remnants of those sinners should be cut off by the morning. The inhabitants of the city came in mad joy at news of the young men. Lut said, "These are my guests. Disgrace me not. Fear Allah and shame me not." They said, "Did we not forbid you to speak for all and sundry?" He said, "They are my daughters to marry if you must act so. Verily, by your life, O Prophet, in their wild intoxication they wander in distraction to and fro. But the mighty blast overtook them before morning. And we turned the cities upside down, and rained down on them brimstones hard as baked clay. Behold, in this are signs for those who by tokens do understand. And the cities were right on the high road. Behold, in this is a sign for those who believe. And the companions of the wood were also wrongdoers. So we exacted retribution from them. They were both on an open highway, plain to see. Companions of the rocky tract also rejected the messengers. We sent them our signs, but they persisted in turning away from them. Out of mountains did they hew their edifices, feeling themselves secure. But the mighty blast seized them of a morning. And of no avail to them was all that they did with such art and care. He created not the heavens, the earth, and all between them, but for just ends. And the hour is surely coming when this will be manifest. So overlook any human faults with gracious forgiveness. For verily, it is your Lord who is the Master Creator, knowing all things. And we have bestowed upon you the seven oft-repeated verses and the Grand Qur'an. Strain not your eyes wistfully at what we have bestowed on certain classes of them, nor grieve over them, but lower your wings in gentleness to the believers. And say, "I am indeed he that warns openly and without ambiguity." Of just such wrath as we sent down on those who divided scripture into arbitrary parts, so also on such as we have made the Quran into shreds as they please. Therefore, by your Lord we will, of a surety, call them to account for all their deeds. Therefore, expound openly what you are commanded, and turn away from those who join false gods with Allah. For sufficient are we unto you against those who scoff. Those who adopt with Allah another God, but soon will they come to know. Do indeed know how your heart is distressed at what they say. But celebrate the praises of your Lord, and be of those who prostrate themselves in adoration. And serve your Lord until they come unto you the hour that is certain.